SCP-3117. Object Class, Euclid. Special Containment Procedures, a Foundation-operated bot, I/O-Spiral, is to monitor online communities for discussions regarding SCP-3117. MTF-511, Promise Keepers, is to investigate these discussions and make a determination for appropriate action on a case-by-case basis. Any materials confirmed to contain components of SCP-3117 are to be isolated if possible, and if not referred to the Foundation's Disinformation Bureau for immediate action. Subjects who have experienced SCP-3117 are to be isolated for study. MTF-10, DAMFEDS, are to continue the ongoing investigation regarding the location featured in Addendum 3117.1, TTT, Description. SCP-3117 is a recurring dream triggered via exposure to certain components. These components take the form of specific ideas, concepts, phrases, and images. While exposure to all components are required to trigger occurrences of SCP-3117, these components can be spread across multiple forms of media, including film, audio, print, and still images. Consequently, no one source is known to contain all components responsible for triggering SCP-3117, although subjects' experiences with SCP-3117 vary. The following symptoms have been noted among those who have or will experience SCP-3117: an aversion to discussing or describing SCP-3117, suspicion that they are receiving warnings regarding SCP-3117, a growing sense of urgency, inevitability, and / dread, the belief that they are being watched. In approximately 1 out of 7 cases, subjects who experience SCP-3117 will go missing shortly after the dream's first occurrence. Investigations into this phenomenon are ongoing. Addendum 3117.1, Discovery. In 2006, a member of the Global Occult Coalition Psyche Division contacted Site-95 with the goal of transferring responsibility for containment of U-2639 Pygmalion Blit over to Foundation care. After several months of negotiation, 378 items, including several hundred documents, digital files, photographs, and one Betamax tape, were taken into Foundation custody. After an extensive clearance process by the on-duty HMCL supervisor, these items have been catalogued as part of SCP-3117's documentation, access:3117/gog/035.log, close file, interview transcript, 15 March 2001, subject, U-2639 Pygmalion Blit, assessment team, 761, Periwinkle, in attendance, 5284128/761, Ladybug, 5288372/761, Voodoo, subject 2639-712, Gamma, Ladybug, tell us about the dream. Gamma, I'm in a woods, or a park, something like that. I'm walking down a path. Concrete, I think. A hiking path. There's something written on the ground. I keep going. Voodoo, what's written? Gamma, I keep going. And, Voodoo, what's written on the ground? Gamma, I don't know. Something like she comes at night? Some spooky shit like that. Voodoo, alright, Ladybug, please, keep going. Gamma, I walk along this path. It starts to curve to the right. I keep walking, and it keeps curving harder and harder to the right, until I realize I'm going in. It's not a circle. More like, a spiral. I'm spiraling towards something. The path is starting to slope down. Ladybug, why are you following this path? Gamma, I don't know. I feel like I have to. It's like I'm on autopilot. I can't stop. Voodoo, what happens then? Gamma, I reach the end of the path. Voodoo, and, Gamma, there's stairs. They lead down. Spiraling down, into the ground. I look down and I can't see the bottom. It's too far, Ladybug. Keep going, Gamma. I go down the stairs. Something's watching, Voodoo. What's watching you, Gamma? And, it's I don't know. Something's watching me. Something's waiting for me at the bottom. But I can't stop. I start going faster and faster, and then I reach the bottom. There's a pit. There's light coming from the pit. I look down, Voodoo, and, Ladybug, you can tell us. It's all right, Gamma, it's something looks back up. That's when I wake up. I wake up screaming, Voodoo, it, Gamma, I don't know. Can we stop? I don't like talking about this. We shouldn't be talking about this, Voodoo, okay. Let's take a short break, okay, Gamma, okay. Access /3117/gok/040.log, close file, video transcript, 17 February 2005, subject, U2639 Pygmalion Blit, discovery date, January 19, 2005, format, standard Betamax tape, length, 68 minutes, 12 seconds, additional notes, discovered by at 761, Periwinkle, at the home of. The tape is labeled Home Movie, 3/8/1983. Midnight, 2 seconds, video begins. Screen displays title for 12 seconds, this is where she appears in the dark of night. 12 seconds, 16 seconds, the camera is focused on a path extending into the forest which curves to the right. Graffiti is visible at the bottom of the frame, it reads, this is where she appears in the dark of night. The camera begins to move forward, following the path for 3 minutes, the next 5 minutes are obscured by static, 8 minutes and 47 seconds, 8 minutes and 55 seconds, the static clears. The camera is focused on a stone staircase that spirals into the earth. 35 seconds pass as it focuses on the view below. The bottom cannot be seen. The camera slowly descends the staircase, 15 minutes and 31 seconds, 15 minutes and 50 seconds, the camera stops descending and turns up to face the entrance. Approximately 20 seconds are spent focused on the entrance, abruptly, the camera turns back to the stairs and proceeds to rapidly descend. Heavy breathing is now audible, 18 minutes and 12 seconds, 18 minutes and 23 seconds, the camera's erratic movements indicate running. A brief shot of the stairway is visible, the bottom still cannot be seen, heavy breathing continues. In addition, there is now a muffled rumbling sound, the next 10 minutes are obscured by static, 28 minutes and 36 seconds, 28 minutes and 41 seconds, the static clears. The camera is now moving significantly slower, maintaining a steady pace. A loud, rhythmic sound reminiscent of large machines grinding is heard. The camera pauses to briefly look down the staircase, the bottom can still not be seen, the next 30 minutes are obscured by static, 59 minutes and 55 seconds, 00:61:17, the static clears. The camera is focused on the edge of a stone railing, beyond it, there is a pit with a bright, glowing light coming from below. The rhythmic sound of metallic grinding continues, the camera approaches the edge of the railing with caution, slowly angling down. The metallic grinding grows louder, the remaining 7 minutes are obscured by static, addendum 3117.2, interview, as part of the agreement between the Foundation and the GOC, the Foundation was permitted to interview a former GOC operative, Jennifer Selwick, who had been part of the assessment team assigned to investigate SCP-3117, access :3117/interview/103.log, close file, interview log, date, 2006/09/19, interviewer, Dr. Jenner, subject, Jennifer Selwick, former GOC operative, begin log, Jenner, what can you tell me about SCP-3117? Subject, you've got all our files on it. What do you want me to tell you, Jenner? the files don't paint the whole picture. Several of them are incomplete, and show signs of damage. Subject: that's probably on account of my team destroying as much of it as we could. Jenner: what may I ask why? Were they? Subject: no. Jenner: cognitohazardous? No. Subject: no. They weren't dangerous in of themselves. Not directly. Jenner: could you elaborate? Subject: look. U-2639, Jenner, SCP-3117, Subject: right, whatever. 3117 it isn't whatever you think it is. There's a reason the GOC stopped looking into it and threw everything I didn't destroy over to you guys, Jenner, and why is that? Subject: we've been investigating this thing for maybe 10, 20 years. And it's eaten its way through, Jenner, eaten, subject, way through a lot of people. Some of our best. Some of our brightest, yeah. We originally thought it was some sort of entity, maybe a type green or type blue, but no, it's nothing like that. It's not even a monster, I don't think. It's just a trap. A monster-shaped hole, Jenner, I'm not sure I, subject, you try to work it out, because that's what you do when you're clever, you work things out. But with every piece you find, you're filling that hole up. You're reassembling a puzzle of your own creation, one you didn't even know you were solving. Until, silence, Jenner, until what? Subject, until the hole isn't a hole anymore. Until it's staring back up at you, Jenner, are you saying SCP-3117 creates some sort of monster? Subject, we think we tell each other scary stories for fun, but maybe there's another reason. I think some of these stories, when we tell them, they're not meant to be thrilling. They're meant to be warnings. A warning to stop. To not open that door, to not go down the stairs. To stop watching the movie, or listening to that story, or reading that article. But you don't realize it? Not until it's too late. Not until, silence, Jenner, Jennifer, silence, Jenner, what's wrong? Subject, it's too late, Jenner, what's too late? Subject, she's found you. I'm sorry. She's found you, Jenner, I don't what? Subject, don't think about it. Don't talk about it. Don't try to figure it out. When the dreams start to come, ignore them. Don't tell anyone. And whatever you do, don't look down. Don't look into the pit. She's found you, and if you keep trying to look, if you keep trying to solve this, she's going to. Jenner, stop. Please, I don't understand what you're. Subject, I'm not talking to you. End log.